Hi, this is Toby with HMC Electronics, a division of Hisco. We're going to be taking a look at the latest and greatest from Hakko, their FR-810. This model replaces the FR-801 and FR-802. The FR-810 has an awful lot of whistles and bells that you gain access to through the parameter settings menu. To try to keep this video short, we actually broke out that into its own separate video, just focusing on adjusting the sleep timer, the auto off, adjusting whether you want it in Celsius or Fahrenheit, and the big one, the preset mode. You can actually daisy chain your 5 presets. And if you think about that, it's rather cool because it enables you to create a reflow profile. So if you are interested in seeing really the inner workings of the FR-810, check out that video on our channel or on the link below. Let's jump into a few specs with regards to the FR-810. This unit is about a half an inch footprint smaller than the FR-801, so a little bit of a size savings. With regards to the heater element, it has been completely redesigned, has a top temperature of 1120 Fahrenheit, putting out 790 watts of power. The airflow at 115 liters per minute from the onboard turbine. This is not a shop air system. This is completely self-contained. And the unit itself is actually surprisingly lightweight, 3.3 pounds. So portable, not that you'd really walk around the facility with it, but good to know. So as I alluded to before, the FR-810 does take a different nozzle. It takes the N51 series. Now, before you moan and complain about having to buy all new nozzles at hundreds of dollars at expense, just like we used to with the old Nintendo game consoles, they actually have provided us with an adapter, and you can purchase this adapter. It's called a B5058. And if you simply just lock this adapter on, like that, you can then take all of your old A series nozzles. This is an A1140B. And just as you would have in the past, adjust the Phillips head screw, put it on, tighten it on, and you're good to go. The N51 nozzles, as you can see, have this kind of turn and lock feature, and they did supply a heat pad for when that nozzle is hot, so you can do an easy change then. Okay, so I've got the FR-810 fired up. I've programmed in some presets just by going through the basics of the parameter menu, which very, very simple. As you can see, as I pull it out here, here we go. So P1 is set for 212 Fahrenheit at a 9 airspeed. I'm gonna go a little bit higher than that. Okay, it's 392, and you've got your airspeed set at 5. I'm gonna enter that one, press my start button. It's gonna start warming up right away. Again, with the safety feature that this unit has, if I put this cubby, this tool back into the cubby, the motor, the air, continues to flow. The heating element has been shut off. So you're going to see the screen now going back down. If I pull it back out, hit the start button, it's going to start ramping right back up to temperature. The FR-810 also has a holder which can be easily removed and swapped onto the other side. If you're a southpaw like myself, a lefty, you get to just simply unscrew these 4 Phillips heads, put the bracket on the other side, and it can be mounted onto the other side of the unit. This stand holder also has a magnet on it, if you can see that right there. That magnet is what actually activates the feature, the shutoff feature for your heating element for safety. When I replace the handle into the holder, what will happen is the airflow will continue. That will be cooling off your heating element, but your heating element power is actually shut off. So if you put this tool away and you continue to hear the turbine inside whirring, nothing's wrong, it's just it's cooling off that heating element and therefore prolonging the life of it. If you have any questions with regards to the FR-810, the prior generation FR-801, 802, or even the next level up, the FR-803 from Hakko, feel free to give us a call, drop us a line. Thanks for watching and happy soldering.